Yeah, so related to these two, three topics, but you should also make, I think you should be able to by now write a text, simple text about your family, about your city, about your hometown. Yeah, those things about your house. So I'm not touching those things, but there are something like a dialogue or something like a letter. I could give you briefly some vocabulary and some, basically you need to know the style, what style is followed and what kind of vocabulary is used, in these particular contexts. So let's begin. We start with the letter first. And imagine yourself like this, something like, here is a letter. Somebody would like to read? Just read the text quickly. Okay, so I'm going to read the letter and then you will probably understand the style also, how it's written, and then I'll also give you some clue about it. So let's begin. Okay, liebe Anna, ich habe lange Zeit. Okay, let's begin by this letter. We'll read two. We have first this one, then we'll go to second one. Liebe Carmen, am kommenden Sonntag habe ich Geburtstag. Ich möchte gern mit dir feiern und lade dich herzlich zu meiner Party am Samstagabend ein. Wir fangen um 21 Uhr an. Ist das okay für dich? Es werden viele Leute da sein, die du auch kennst. Kannst du vielleicht einen Salat mitbringen? Und vergiss bitte nicht einen Pullover oder eine Jacke. Wir wollen nämlich draußen im Garten feiern. Ich freue mich sehr auf dich. Bis zum Wochenende, Ralf. Okay, so here you see, first I'll talk about the how do you write. So suppose you are writing letter to a girl, then you use liebe. Carmen is a girl here. So liebe, if it is a boy, then you will use lieber. Yeah, so lieber Ralph. For example, if Carmen is responding to this mail, she will write lieber Ralph. Okay, then after that you have comma, and when you start the letter, the first initial letter of the first word will be small letter, as you can see here, so because it's in the continuation, there is a comma and then you're starting to speak, right? So that's how it goes. So you write the first letter in the small letter and the first letter of the first word, and then you make your own body. Here's few lines are very simple, but few lines are a bit complicated. So you don't need to write such complicated lines, which like the grammar that we haven't learned. For example, imagine that you are Ralph and you are trying to respond to Carmen. How will you write now? You are Carmen and you are responding to Ralph. So how will you do that? What will we say? First line, we'll say, lieber Ralph. Yeah. Then he is saying, am kommenden Sonntag habe ich Geburtstag. Ich möchte gern mit dir feiern und lade dich herzlich zu meiner Party am Samstagabend ein. So on coming Saturday, Sunday, I have birthday. I would like to celebrate with you and I invite you to my party on Sunday evening. Okay, so what will you do? Probably you'll say thank you for the invitation. No, so how do we say that? Danke für. One second. I'm just getting the symbol here. Yeah? So we can say danke für. Einladung. Yeah, first line. Then you can say, then this person is asking, she's asking you, he is asking you if you will be able to come. Like, I'm inviting you. So you say thank you. Then you can say, I would love to come to your party. Yeah. Ich komme gern zu deiner Party am Samstag. Yeah. Wir fangen 21 Uhr an. We will begin. Here the separable verb has been used. Anfangen. Anfangen means to begin. We begin at 9 o'clock. Is this okay for your dish? You can say, if you think it's okay, you can say okay. Ich komme ein und zwanzig Uhr. Ist okay für. Yeah, then es werden viele Leute da sein. This is a little bit complicated. We don't, if you're writing, you can write simpler lines. No, die du auch kennst. Yeah, okay, then kannst du vielleicht einen Salat mitbringen? Now, the next question is, can you bring a salad? You can say, yeah, I'm just putting it. You can also change the paragraph or you can continue in the same way. Yeah, ich bringe einen Salat mit. Yes, I'll bring a salad. Und vergiss bitte nicht einen Pullover oder eine Jacke. That is information, so you don't need to respond to it. And don't forget a pullover or a jacket. Wir wollen nämlich draußen im Garten feiern. We want to celebrate in the garden. Okay, so you can say then that, ja, ich bringe einen Salat mit. Then, ich freue mich sehr auf this. I'm looking forward to you. You can say the same thing. Ich freue mich sehr auf this. Bis, you can also say bis zum Wochenende and comma. There is no comma. I think there should be a comma. And then you can say Carmen. Sorry. Yes, you can say Carmen. Okay, so you end the same way. So you see, it's really simple to respond to this letter. No. Now the next letter is just a first letter. We'll move to the first. And this you can just use to practice. Here also you have somebody talking. And First is begrüßung. Here, liebe Anna. After Anna, there is an exclamation. And that's why the next sentence starts with capital I. But normally, we don't put an exclamation. We just put a comma. Yeah, so you simply put a comma. And then there are questions. You read the mail and you see the questions around here. You have to respond to them. Yeah, in your response. So this is a letter, read it, then imagine that you are Anna and you respond to Suji's mail. This is for you to try by yourself if you want to practice a little bit. So this is the informal letter. That's how we write. Yeah, normally I'll just give you some tips or you can just see here.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, when do we use exclamation? Like, because in some sentences, there's exclamation. In some sentences, just a full stop.
Yeah, it's also very subjective. You know, when do we use exclamation? Whenever you are surprised or you are too happy or you want to emphasize too much. So it's an expression of that. No, exclamation is basically that. Okay, but sometimes if there is instruction also, there is exercise and instruction is being given there also, we do see time to time that there is exclamation. But exclamation is basically that there is an element of surprise, no, or happiness, I guess. So that's when you do. So in this one, you don't need to really follow everything, but you can get some idea like briefer schreiben means letter writing. Okay, so it's a mix of formal and informal letter. Normally when you write a formal letter, then you write date. No, informal letters normally we don't have, but you can also still write. You can write the dates, like place and then the date. Then unreader means how do we address. Yeah, okay, it's all informal, it's nothing is formal here. Yes, so on the top you can write the dates, then lieber Heike, lieber Johann, lieber Müllers. Okay, so that's how we address. The first two addresses, one is for girl, the second one is for boy. Third one is for the family. Suppose you are writing to whole family together, then Müllers is the second name. And then Familie van Feschner is again the family. Yes, you are talking to the whole family. So let's stick to the first two ones. No, when you are addressing somebody individually, with the first name. So that's one. Then Einführung. Einführung is introduction. There are variations how you can introduce a letter, begin a letter. Ich habe deinen Brief bekommen. I have got your letter. Ich freue mich sehr darüber. I'm very happy about it. Danke für deine Ansichtskarte. Not so important. Ansichtskarte is like postcard or the that just somebody sends. No, thank you for that. So it's very content oriented. Not everything is will be relevant all the time. Then entschuldige, das ist so lange mich nicht geschrieben habe. This is past tense. We no need to use. So just skip this. Yeah, I'll come to the Schluss. Schluss means how do you end the letter. Jetzt beende ich meinen Brief. This is something that you can use. Now I end my letter. Das ist alles für heute. That's all for today. Ich muss mich beeilen. I must rush. Ich warte auf deine Antwort. I'll wait for your letter. Mit freundlichen Grüßen, with friendly greetings. Viele Grüße. Yeah, a lot of greetings. And in the end, you can say dein. If you are a boy answering to a letter, then you say dein. If you're a girl, then you say deiner. Yeah. we just stay up to first one. Okay, so you, when you are ending the letter, you have to say three different variations are there. You can say feel aggrusso, as you can see here. You talked about greetings here in this context. Yeah, no need to say. We can give the exclamation, or we can also simply say filo gruso, and then put comma. Both possibility is there, but I think we normally we put exclamation with this. Yeah, filo gruso, you put an exclamation, then you say thine. And then you tell Peter, or you say Dina, and you say Monica. No, yours Peter, yours Monica. So filagrusa is one. Second is, you can also say liebe Grusa. Okay. Third, you can say mit Herz. Listen, Grusen, yeah, you can also say this. So three different ways you can conclude a mail. So this is how you practice. You try to practice writing a letter, looking at the first one. Okay, this is one topic that we wanted to talk about. I wanted to talk about. Now let's move to the next one, where we'll talk about how do you converse in a supermarket. No, very simple lines. So suppose there is a dialogue between a salesperson and a customer. So how does it work? So is anyone interested in reading it? Come forward. Abhinav, would you like to read? There are two role players. One is verkäufer. Verkäufer means the salesperson, then you have käufer. Käufer means buyer or the customer. So, would you like to read? Shashank, would you like to read?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. And somebody with you. Shruti, are you there? Okay. Okay, Shashank, you read with me. Okay. So, guten Tag.
Hallo, was kostet ein Kilo Bananen?
Ein Kilo Bananen kostet 2,45 €.
Was kosten 2 Kilo Tomaten?
2 Kilo Tomaten kosten 7,34 €.
Was kostet ein Stück Salat?
Okay, ein Stück Salat kostet 75 Cent.
Und was kosten 2 Melonen?
2 Melonen kosten 2 €. What is this? What digit is that? 9? After that?
I think 1.
Yeah, 1? Okay,
eins.
Whatever. Okay, 2 € eins. Is it 1? It's a little bit tricky. So whatever it is, if it is swai oiro noinsish scent, let me go with that. Swai oiro noinsish. Continue.
Ish nema ein stuk zalat und swai kilo bananen.
Okay, das macht 5 euro 63.
Hier sind 6 euro. Stimmt so.
So, stimmt so.
Stimmt so.
Danke, auf Wiedersehen.
Tschüss.
Yeah, there is a mistake in tschüss. There will be double S. So remember that you have to write double S and no need to say stimmt so. Yeah. Hier sind 6 Euro. Okay. Is it okay? Stimmt so. Is it fine? Yeah. We don't need to say hier sind 6 Euro is enough to say. As you see, this person in this dialogue, somebody is inquiring, like asking about all the stuff and then deciding what to buy. No, he is just taking ein Stück, ich nehme ein Stück Salat und 2 Kilo Bananen. So then you calculate the price, the smart, this whatever. So this is one way you can make very simple conversation in a supermarket. You ask about the price and all that. So I want to say that if you are asking about something 1 kilo, as you can see the first sentence, was costed 1 kilo bananen? What costs 1 kg of banana? Yeah, bananas. Then 1 kilo bananen costed whatever price. But if it becomes 2 kilo, then in that case, we don't say costed. What do we say? We say costed. That's important. Yeah. So when 1 kg, it's considered as singular, though banana is plural, but because of the quantity of kg, you decide whether to use singular form or plural form. So this is one thing you pay attention to. So when to use costed and when to use costen. Okay. And das macht, this expression we learn, das macht means this makes. Yeah, this makes this much money. So you have to pay me this much money. Yeah, it's like calculating and telling the price. Okay, so this is one simple exercise. Now, let's move to the next one. Here, if you want to know about the vocabulary, you can find more vocabulary here. Okay, I think this font is very small. I need to wear glasses. Okay, so here you see, again, you can just check out what more do you think you need, you can buy in the supermarket. So here it gives you the list of those stuff. You can go about it. So maybe you can read it. I don't want to take much of your time. I don't know. So we can, I'm trying to just give you some idea about what kind of vocabulary you can expect and what you need to include. So what you do, you go read it alone, these texts, like what all can you buy in supermarket. You buy tomato, you buy orange, you buy milk, yeah, butter, so broth. So you will get certain idea about the vocabulary. No? Was habe ich zu Hause? Ich habe noch Bananen und Orangen in der Küche, aber ich habe keine Milch. Ich habe auch keine Butter. Ich möchte auch Marmelade kaufen. So Marmelade, as you know, jam, Milch, Butter. So you get certain idea about that. So go through this vocabulary. And also next one. Here, another conversation. This is a little bit complicated. So this is just to have more vocabulary. But when, suppose you are supposed to write a dialogue in case, then it's enough if you follow this style, like simple sentences. You can make You can just practice, make a mix of all different kind of expressions. Take from here, take from here, and little bit take from here. But yeah, for example, Anna Mueller is the customer, Verkäuferin. In the first text you had was, there was a Verkäufer, salesman. Here there is a sales girl. So the Verkäuferin, so certain expressions are very simple and nice. For example, maybe Shashank, we can read it together if you like. So we'll get used to it. Would you like to read?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you start.
Yes. Entschuldigen Sie bitte.
Entschuldigen Sie bitte.
Entschuldigen Sie bitte.
Ja, bitte.
Können Sie mir helfen?
Was suchen Sie denn?
Wo gibt's hier denn Milch?
Milch, gleich hier vorne links, bei den Milchprodukten.
Und wo finde ich Marmelade?
Ganz hinten, im letzten Gang, im dritten Regal.
Ich brauche auch noch Kekse.
Brauche? Yeah.
Ich okay. brauche auch noch Kekse.
Ich glaube da hinten, rechts.
Und wo ist der Joghurt?
Im nächsten Gang links.
Oben oder unten?
In der Mitte.
Wo findet man Waschmittel?
Ja, hier unten bei den Haushaltswaren.
Ich suche auch Fisch.
Im vorletzten Gang bei der Tiefkühlkost.
Und Pralinen?
Tut mir leid, das weiß ich auch nicht. Fragen Sie doch mal an der Kasse.
Ich danke Ihnen.
Nicht zu danken. So you see, in the first text that we saw there, it was about the price. The customer is inquiring about the price. Here, it's the person is asking about where is what, no? So this couple of lines are, anyway, you can include, Entschuldigen Sie bitte, excuse me, please. Ja, bitte, yes, please. Können Sie mir helfen? Can you help me? Was suchen Sie denn? What are you looking for? Wo gibt es hier denn Milch? Where is the milk? Milch, gleich hier vorne links bei den Milchprodukten. These expressions, if you are comfortable, then use. Otherwise, no need to use at this level. Right here in the front, right on the left side, where there are by the milk products, no? Where there are milk products. Then, okay, so just let's not spend much time talking about it. Yeah, just get whatever vocabulary you get from here. Okay, quickly I can tell you though. Something marmalade, ganz hinten im letzten Gang, im dritten Regal. Where is the marmalade? It's completely like at the back in the last row on the third shelf. No, ich brauche auch noch Kekse. Kekse is cookies. I also need cookies. Ich glaube da hinten rechts. I believe it's there behind right side. Rechts means right side. Links means left side. And wo ist der Joghurt? Im nächsten Gang links. Where is the yogurt? On the next row, left side. Oben oder unten? Oben means above, unten means below, above or below. In der Mitte, in the middle. Yeah. Then wo findet man Waschmittel? Waschmittel is the washing material, detergent, soap, etc. Here unten, here below, bei den Haushaltswaren, where there are household stuff. Ich suche auch Fisch. I'm also looking for fish. Im vorletzten Gang bei der Tiefkühlkost, where they keep the frozen stock. So it's in the second last. Vorletzten means second last row where they keep the frozen stuff. Und Pralinen. Pralinen is the candies. Then she says, tut mir leid. I'm sorry. Das weiß ich auch nicht. I also don't know it. Fragen Sie doch mal an der Kasse. Please ask at the counter. An der Kasse means at the counter. So ich danke Ihnen. I thank you. Nicht zu danken. Not to thank. Not like it's in a way to say. Yeah. Like nicht zu danken. There is nothing to thank about. Okay, so let's so focus on this. Now, same way, you have here the conversation, kind of conversation you can do in the restaurant. Okay, here again, you have Kellner. Kellner is the waiter. Then you have guest. So you can make a conversation between Kellner and guest. I would advise you to just go about it yourself and you can just find and get some idea or we got one more. You can just check out both. Yeah, here you have a girl who is a waitress, Kellnerin and Gast. In the previous one, you have Kellner und Gast. This is a simpler one, the first one that we have here. You can see, was möchten Sie bestellen? Bestellen means order. What would you like to order? So the guest is saying, ich möchte Pommes with ketchup, einen Wiener Schnitzel und Salat essen. I would like to eat this. Yeah, as I told you this morning while doing modal verb in restaurant, when we talk, we use the modal verb möchten. And you can also replace it with your own menu, like anything. It could be anything that you eat. No, doesn't have to be very European only. Then was möchten Sie trinken? Einen Orangensaft bitte, orange juice please. Möchten Sie auch einen Nachtisch? Nachtisch means dessert. Do you also like to have dessert? Ein Eis bitte, an ice cream please. Und Sie? Kellner is asking to the next guest, and you, das gleiche für mich bitte. Das gleiche means the same for me, please. Yeah. So here, gleich has been used as a noun. That's why it's capital. You can see, das gleiche für mich bitte. Okay. So this is the conversation which follows. Then the next conversation is here bitte. She brings the order, whatever food they ordered. They say danke. Guest one is telling to Kellner danke. Then now they are talking to each other, the guests. Guten Appetit, danke, ebenfalls, zum Wohl. Yeah. So guten Appetit. Well, before you sit to eat, you say guten Appetit. Then danke, the other guest says danke, ebenfalls means same to you. You can also use in the place of ebenfalls, gleichfalls. Yeah, gleichfalls means also same to you. Okay, then second guest is saying zum Wohl, Prost. Before somebody drinks something, one says Prost. So it's in that context, cheers, yeah. So maybe it's related to that. Then the next scene is that they will pay. So guest one, Herr Kellner, wir möchten zahlen. Mr. Wetter, we would like to pay. And Kellner is saying, alles zusammen oder getrennt. This is very peculiar. Sentence, it's used in a restaurant. Suppose you go in Germany, they always ask if you go together with your friends, would you like to pay together or separate? So all together, alles zusammen means all together, or separate, oder getrennt. So guest one is saying zusammen. So that means one person will pay for all. So Kellner says then, calculates all the money and says, 15 euro 15 means 15 euro 50 cents. Gastmann, wie bitte? Was costed this? This is weird. Kellner, 15 euro 15, hier bitte. Kellner, vielen Dank und einen schönen Tag noch. I would not bring this dramatic element in the middle. Maybe Kellner, 15 euro 15, and then it can be. Hier bitte, and then vielen Dank, thank you very much, und einen schönen Tag noch, means a beautiful day to you. Okay, auf Wiedersehen. So you have this, and the next one, you try to follow it, okay? And we stop. So all the best now for the exam. You have any question, anything you want to ask?
Ma'am, how...